गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी दिस बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन एंड द नेक्स्ट पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द किंगडम एनिमेलिया. इन किंगडम एनिमेलिया यू हैव स्टडीड द नॉन कॉर्डेट्स एंड देयर क्लासिफिकेशन. इन दिस पार्ट यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द फाइलम कॉर्डेटा एंड ऑल द दैट ग्रुप्स विच बिलोंग टू द फाइलम कॉर्डेटा. दिस इज द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द यूनिट वन एंड आफ्टर दिस द यूनिट वन विल बी completed. So let me start with the chordates. Phylum Chordata has the following characteristic features. What are the characteristic features? They have notochord. So they possess notochord, dorsal hollow nerve cord is present in them, and paired gill slits. So all these three features they are present at some stage of their life. They possess notochord, dorsal hollow nerve cord, and paired pharyngeal gill slits are there. So gills are present. So all these three features they are present at some stage of their life. And notochord is the structure which further develops into vertebral column in the vertebrates. Level of organization, they show organ system level of organization. Organ system like the respiratory system, digestive system, they have all the organs in them, and all these organs together they are responsible to perform a particular function like digestion, respiration. Like for digestion there is digestive system, for respiration there is respiratory system. So they show organ level of organization. Then diploblastic or triploblastic organization. So they show triploblastic organization. Triploblastic means here the three germ layers are present. You have studied in the animal construction already that ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm. These all three germ layers are present at the embryonic stage. So triploblastic organization. Symmetry, they show bilateral symmetry. So they are bilaterally symmetrical. Coelom, they have coelom, that is why they are known as the coelomate. Segmentation, body is not divided into segments, so they show unsegmented body. They have closed circulatory system where the blood flows through the vessels, and they possess a postanal tail, and development is usually direct. Sometimes larva is involved in the development. Heart is always on the ventral side and it is being myogenic. Hemoglobin is present inside the RBCs. So all these are the features of the phylum Chordata. You have to learn this identifying features: notochord, dorsal hollow nerve cord, and paired pharyngeal gill slits. These are the key features of the phylum Chordata. You see here that this is the dorsal hollow nerve cord. Then this is notochord. So this notochord further develops into vertebral column in the vertebrates. Then pharyngeal gill slits in pharynx region. These gill slits are present, and postanal tail. So characteristic features of Chordata. Now we'll study the classification. Phylum Chordata has been divided into three subphyla: Urochordata, Cephalochordata, and Vertebrata. So this division is done on the basis of the presence of notochord in them at the different stages of their life. Means urochordata, that they are most primitive chordates, and notochord, it is confined to the tail region only. Uro means tail. So in the tail region only it is confined, that is why they are urochordata. Cephalochordata, cephalic region means here what notochord, it extends from head region. Cephalic region means from head to tail region. And in the vertebrata, this notochord is found in embryonic stage only. It is replaced by vertebral column after the or during the development. So later it is this notochord replaced by the vertebral column in the vertebrata. Further, vertebrata is divided into two divisions, that is agnatha and nethostomata. Agnatha, they do not have the jaw. Agnatha means without jaw. A means without here. Natha means jaw. So they do not have the jaws. Nethostomata, they have jaws in them. Agnatha has only one class, that is cyclostomata. Nethostomata further divided into two superclasses, that is Pisces all the fishes they come under Pisces and tetrapoda. Tetra means four, poda means limbs. So they have four limbs. So they bear limbs. That is why the organisms they come under the tetrapoda. Tetrapoda is further divided into four classes: amphibia, reptilia, aves, and mammalia. Pisces further divided into two classes: chondrichthyes and osteichthyes. Chondrichthyes cartilaginous fishes, osteichthyes bony fishes. So let we study all these that phyla and classes in detail. So we will start here subphylum Urochordata. So as I said, you know Urochordata is known as the tunicata also. So they are the most primitive chordates, and notochords remains confined to tail region, as I explained you just now. So notochord, it is in the tail region only. And formation of the tadpole larva. So during their embryonic development, formation of tadpole larva is there. It undergoes retrogressive metamorphosis. What is the meaning of retrogressive? Means not being progressive. Means tadpole larva has all the that features of the chordata, which further undergo reduction in the adult. So this is retrogressive metamorphosis. And sac like unsegmented body enclosed in a leathery test. So that body covering is in the form of leathery test or tunic. That is why its another name is tunicata, also name of the subphylum. So sac like unsegmented body enclosed in a leathery test or tunic made up of tunicin. Examples: Ascidia, Hardmania, Doliolum. This is the diagram of Hardmania, you can see here. And these are the atrial aperture and brachial aperture, and this is tunic, which is made up of tunicin. So you see the tunicate's life cycle. Here you see the larva. In larval stage, you can see this notochord, dorsal hollow nerve cord also, and the pharyngeal gill slits also. All these three features, they are the defining features of the chordates. But as this that larval stage undergoes further development, then the adult, it loses the notochord and the dorsal nerve cord also. So this reduction makes it the retrogressive metamorphosis. Means these developed features of the chordate, they undergo reduction when this larva develops into the adult. So understood retrogressive metamorphosis. Now we'll see the subphylum Cephalochordata. They retain chordate characters throughout their life. Like in Urochordata, you have studied that the chordate characters are found only in the larva, that is at the larval stage. But in the subphylum Cephalochordata, the organisms, they retain their chordate characters throughout their life. Means all these nerve cord, notochord and gills are present throughout their life. Notochord extends from head to tail region. So you can see here, this is notochord and found right from head to the tail region. Then dorsal hollow nerve cord is also present. Then presence of wheel organ or Muller's organ. So this structure is present here in the mouth region, and it helps in the process of feeding. Ciliary and filter feeders, mucus feeders. What does it mean? That here the movement of cilia, you can see here the tentacles are there, and in the mouth the cilia are also there. So movement of the cilia, it actually directs the water current towards their mouth, and further water, it undergoes filtration. It undergoes filtration means cilia that helps filters this water, and microorganism, they remain outside. Rest of the water enters into the mouth. So this is the ciliary and that filter feeding. And examples are there amphioxus and brachiostoma also, that is known as the lancelet. So that is the another name here, the of the amphioxus, that is brachiostoma. So only one example in the subphylum Cephalochordata. Now next we'll study subphylum Vertebrata. Subphylum Vertebrata means notochord. So notochord is present only in embryonic stage. Later it is replaced by the vertebral column. Two pairs of appendages are present, fins or limbs. So in fishes, like you see the fins, and in other organism limbs are present. Nerve cord enclosed within the vertebral column, because this notochord, it develops into the vertebral column, and this vertebral column that has the nerve cord in its inner cavity, neural cavity, in which the nerve cord runs. Then the brain lodged in the cartilaginous or the bony cranium. So cranium is the hard covering, bony covering of the brain. This subphylum Vertebrata has been divided into two groups, Agnatha and Nathostomata. In Agnatha, the notochord persists in the adults, means adults they have notochord, and true jaws are absent in them. Paired appendages are absent, and only two semicircular canals are present in the internal ears. You have studied the three semicircular canals in human ear. So that belongs to the Nathostomata, but in Agnatha only two semicircular canals are present in the internal ear. Only one class is there in the group Agnatha, that is class Cyclostomata. Circular funnel shaped suctorial mouth with horny teeth for sucking the blood from the body of the prey. So mouth is funnel shaped, circular and suctorial, which sucks the blood of the prey. 6 to 15 pairs of gill slits are present, and scales and paired fins are absent. Examples, Petromyzon and Myxin. Petromyzon, they are known as the lamprey, and Myxin commonly known as the hagfish also. Now next we will study Nathostomata. Nathostomata means they have jaw in them. True jaws are present. Agnatha without jaws, and here Nathostomata true jaws are present. Paired appendages are also present, either fins or limbs. Notochord is found only in the embryonic life. It is later replaced by vertebral column. Internal ear has the semicircular canals, and how many semicircular canals? Three semicircular canals are there. This group is further divided into two superclasses, that is Pisces and Tetrapoda. So in Pisces, we'll study the fishes. So all the fishes come under Pisces. They are exclusively aquatic, either freshwater or marine. Respiration by gills, scales on the body, paired fins present in them, fins which help them to swim in the water, streamlined body. So this streamlined body means pointed at both the ends, and in this manner it helps them to penetrate themselves in the water and helps in swimming. And two-chambered heart present in them. So two-chambered heart means one auricle and one ventricle. Only venous blood passes through the heart. And the superclass Pisces is further divided into two major classes, that is ostic thighs and chondrichthyes. Chondrichthyes means they are cartilaginous fishes. Cartilaginous fishes means their skeleton is made up of cartilage. So they are marine cartilaginous fishes. Mouth is subterminal, situated on the ventral side. So mouth is on ventral side. Scroll valve is present in the intestine. Tail is heterocercal. Heterocercal means there are two unequal lobes in the tail fin. Placoid scales present on the body. No operculum. Operculum, which is the covering of the gills. So there is no operculum, hence the gill slits are exposed, and swim bladder is absent. Swim bladder is actually that gas or air containing organ which is responsible, means making the body to float in the water, does not allow the animal to sink, but it is absent in chondrichthyes. So they have to swim actively to avoid sinking in the water. So they continuously swim because swim bladder is absent in them. Examples are dogfish, scolyodon, here the stingray, trigon, electric ray, torpedo and chimera. These all are the examples of chondrichthyes. And these are the examples of chondrichthyes, pictures of the chondrichthyes. So you see here, this is scolyodon, that is the dogfish, and you see that position of the mouth is on the ventral side, subterminal ventral side. This is the lateral line, and you see all these are the fins. So paired fins are there, upper side the dorsal fin, lower side here the pectoral fins, and this is the second dorsal fin. And this is the pelvic fin, claspers, and this is the caudal fin. As I said you, the tail is heterocercal, means two unequal lobes are present in the tail fin or caudal fin. Other examples of the chondrichthyes are there, stingray, that is trigon, and this is electric ray, that is the torpedo. So these are the examples of cartilaginous fish. Now osteichthyes means bony fishes. Bony fishes means their skeleton is made up of bones. Found in both freshwater and marine habitats. Mouth is being terminal, not subterminal as in the chondrichthyes. It is terminal and anteriorly placed. Tail is homocercal because equal sized lobes of the tail fin are found in them. Scales may be cycloid, ectinoid or ganoid, different type of scales. Gills covered with operculum, that is the outer covering of the gills. Lateral line system is present. It acts as sense organs. Swim bladder is present in them. And this again, the swim bladder, I'll tell you that that gas filled organ in the body cavity, which helps them to swim, to maintain buoyancy, so they do not sink in the water. And without moving their fins, it may stay in the water without sinking. So this swim bladder is present in them. And examples are Exocetus, flying fish, hippocampus, seahorse, remora, suckerfish, Lebiorohita, Velegoattu, Mr. Singhala. All these are the examples of bony fishes. So you see here, rohu, that is the Lebiorohita. They are edible fishes. So here you'll see the mouth, that is the mouth is terminal and anteriorly placed, and this is eye, head region, and here you'll see the operculum. This is operculum, that is the covering of the that gills. These are the fins, pelvic fins, pectoral fins. This is dorsal fin and this is caudal fin. Okay, that is tail fin. It has the homocercal condition, means both the lobes in the tail fin, they are equal. So, understood children, the key features of the osteichthyes. This is another example, seahorse, and this is flying fish. Now, subclasses, here further, the superclasses, tetrapoda. So, tetrapoda, this is characterized by the presence of four limbs. It is divided into four classes. These are amphibia, reptilia, avies and mammalia. Class amphibia, it is adapted for both aquatic as well as terrestrial life. So, some part of their life cycle they complete in water and that other part in the land. That is why they are adapted for both aquatic as well as terrestrial life. So, they are placed in amphibia. Amphi means both. Understood? So, they are able to, or they are adapted to survive on both the mode, aquatic and terrestrial life. Two pairs of pentadactyl limbs. Pentadactyl means there are five digits are there in the limbs. And well-developed girdles are there, pelvic girdle, pectoral girdle. Heart is three-chambered. Here, sinus venosus and truncus arteriosus are present in them. That is a part of heart. RBCs are nucleated. Nucleus is present in the RBCs. दे आर कोल्ड ब्लडेड और द पोइकिलोथर्म्स और एक्टोथर्म्स. मीनिंग ऑफ दैट कोल्ड ब्लडेड मीन्स दे आर नॉट एबल टू मेंटेन देयर बॉडी टेम्परेचर एज विद द सराउंडिंग्स टेम्परेचर. सो एज द सराउंडिंग द टेम्परेचर चेंजेस देयर बॉडी टेम्परेचर ऑल्सो चेंजेस. So they are cold blooded, not able to maintain their body temperature. Respiration by skin, lungs, hair or gills also, because by skin here their skin is being moist, so in water it helps in the respiration. Lungs on the land part and the gills are there in at the that larval stage. Sexes are separate and fertilization is external. Examples are frog, that is Rana tigrina, and toad, that is Bufo salamander. So this is that frog and toad. You just see here that here that webbed feet and that moist skin here that helps them to survive in the water also. And development is indirect in them, because it involves a larva, that is tadpole larva, and they are anamniotes, means amniotic, that membrane does not develop in them. There are many features, so any five that features you will learn. Reptilia, in them the skin is covered by the dry scale, so they are first truly successful terrestrial vertebrates. Their skin is covered by dry scales. Monocondylic skull. Monocondylic means single occipital condyle. Mono means single, condylic means the condyle. So here occipital condyle is actually the structure, that is the projection of the occipital bone in the skull. With the help of that, it attaches itself with the first cervical vertebrae, that is atlas. So they have only single occipital condyle in the skull, that is why monocondylic skull. Three chambered heart they have, but there is a one exception also, that four chambered heart is found in crocodile, while other that members of reptilia, they have three chambered heart. Ventricle is incompletely divided, and they have metanephric kidneys. First amniotes means amniotic membrane, it develops in the embryo. And internal fertilization is found in them. Megalocytal egg. Megalocytal egg means egg has a lot of yolk. That is why megalocytal egg, enclosed in the calcareous shell, hard covering of the egg, that is made up of that calcium. And examples are there here the chelon, that is turtle. Testudo, tortoise, chameleon, tree lizard, crocodilus, crocodile, alligator, naja, that is cobra, bangurus, that is crate, vipera. These are the examples of the reptilia. You just see, and the tortoise, it is shown here, the desert tortoise here. So this is the hard outer that covering, you will see dome shell, which is known as the carapace. These are the limbs, four limbs are there. And here you see the crocodile also. This is the hard, that is skinny, dry scales are present on the skin just for protection. This is cobras, kind of snake, chameleon, lizard, and here the wall lizard is also the example of the reptilia. And this is over class reptilia. Now we will study the class avs. In class avs, these are the that birds, all the birds belong to the class avs, and birds are glorified reptiles. This is said by Huxley. So during that evolution, we will study that the birds, they have evolved from the reptiles. Their four limbs are modified into wings, which help them to fly. Presence of feathers, so these all wings and feathers, they help them to fly. Warm blooded means they are able to maintain their body temperature, means their body temperature does not fluctuate as the change takes place or fluctuation takes place in the surrounding temperature. So they are able to maintain their body temperature. Hollow or pneumatic bones are there, air spaces in the bones making them light. So this type of bones are known as the pneumatic bones. Here keeping the body weight less, and skull is monocondylic. Here I explained you what is the meaning of it. Jaws, they are replaced by toothless beak. So at the place of jaws or mouth, here beak is here present. Keel or carina. So this is projection present on sternum. Sternum is the chest bone. So sternum bears a projection called keel or carina for the attachment of the flight muscles. And syrinx present on the ventral side of trachea to produce sound, as we have larynx. Birds, they have syrinx on the ventral side of trachea. Heart is four chambered and RBCs are nucleated, means nucleus is present, and only left kidney and left ureter present in them. So all these features, urinary bladder is also absent. They are uricotelic, means uric acid is the excretory product. And ovary and oviduct also, only the left side they are present, and left kidney and left ureter is only present in them. So they also produce egg. So eggs are enclosed within a calcareous shell. So all these features, they support aerial life, means they fly. So these features, the presence of feathers, pneumatic bones, they all help them to lead their aerial mode of life. And now the examples we will see here: ostrich, mynna, parrot, sparrow, rhea, penguin. Some these are flightless birds, penguin and all this. And here you will see like the that white stork. Then here you will see the duck also, ostriches, then pigeon, sparrow, crow. So all these are examples of the birds. Now the next class we will study mammalia. So in mammalia, body is covered with hair. Presence of mammary gland, that is the characteristic feature of mammalia. Mammary gland, sweat gland and sebaceous glands are present. 7 cervical vertebrae, thicodont and heterodont. Thicodont means their teeth are embedded in the jaw, and heterodont means different type of teeth they have. Like you have studied the dental formula and teeth, that incisors, canines, molars, premolars, the different type of teeth structurally. So this condition is known as the heterodont. Presence of diaphragm, warm-blooded, that is homeothermal, means able to maintain their body temperature. Body temperature does not fluctuate with the surrounding temperature. And RBCs, enucleated, means RBCs are circular and without nucleus. Pinna present, that is external ear. Heart is four-chambered. Fertilization internal. Viviparous, means they give birth to young ones. The development of that young ones is taking place in the female, in the uterus of the female, that is viviparous, giving young birth to the young ones. So one exception is there in viviparity, that is except prototherians, all are viviparous. Amniotes, that is amniotic membrane develops in the embryonic development. And placentas, means placenta is the structure which connects the fetus and the mother in order to provide the nutrition and for all other purposes. So all these are the features of class mammalia. Examples: Panthera tigris, tiger, Homo sapiens sapiens, man itself, rhesus macaca, that is rhesus monkey, Elephas maximus, that is elephant. So with these mammals, you all are means knowing it very well. All these that mammals are there, you just see here, that is the zebra here. And some of the mammals, they survive in water also, you know, that blue whale. And these are the flying mammals, Chiroptera, bats are there, elephant, kangaroo. So there are many examples here. Just see the rabbit, squirrels, deer. So all they belong to the class mammalia.